the Mulberry Show. It's not really something I typically do, but I thought it was a good one. You know, most of my luggage is Mulberry. I'm a fan, so excited to see the show.
What I love is at Mulberry, everyone brings their dogs, and there's dogs on the catwalk. And every year, it looks like there's going to be a massive punch-up of dogs. I say no way, try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales. I just won't play, letting my life get away.
Great vibe, amazing mix between Cleopatra mood, the Let's Tale of Magic World, and youthness, contemporary modern attitude. I love
it. What tips would you give us for next season from what you've seen on the catwalk so far?
I mean, my tips is generally try, go bold, don't get lazy. Try your mood, change your mood, change yourself. Fashion is that one, it's about change.
We're here at Matthew Williamson. What is it do you love about his design?
Well, I mean, not only is he one of my sort of closest friends, he's just, you know, I love what he does every season. I think he's like still evolving as a designer. Every time he comes out with something new and fresher. I love the way he uses colour and texture and print. And, you know, he's kind of the god of embellishment, you know, he knows how to do it.
Initially in my mood board, and it was about making a relaxed, languid, sexy modern collection.
And the girls were looking really fresh. What were you, when you were casting, were you kind of a certain aesthetic?
I just wanted like really juicy colours, like the sunset, and girls that just want to be cool and laid back and a little bit bohemian, but not a collection about beach and holiday. It was more of an urban wardrobe.
Stunning. I think it's his best collection yet. The colours were beautiful, the feathers, the embroidery, and I just thought it was stunning. I'm really proud.
And your experiences at all?
Keep talking, because otherwise some blogger will take my seat.
Yeah, that's true.
Trust me, it happens.
When was the last time a blogger took your seat, and who was it?
At Henry Holland's show, some blogger with an urchin bun just came and took my... I'd stood up to like help an old lady cross the street or something, and help an old lady cross the catwalk. This blogger just zoomed in, front row seat, you know, that's worth good money in North London, so it went. And do you know what, I didn't kick up a fuss, because I said to her, if it means that much to you to sit here, then I want you to sit here.
Enjoy your martini, they're pretty strong, aren't they?
And I am a fan of Grazia. I'm one of those people who says they don't buy it or don't read it. Well, I don't buy it. One of those people who says they don't read it, but of course I do, when there's a copy lying around, as do all men who say they don't.
Try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales. I just won't play, letting my life get away. I know for love.
Have you had a great fashion week so far? Has it been?
It's fantastic, it's really great. You know, just Jonathan Thorne was lovely. You know, I just it's been good. I think we should be really proud. I mean, tomorrow's going to be the big day as well. I'm a bit exhausted, as always. And of course, there's about 5 flights of stairs. Look at my shoes.
Yeah, very inspired by kind of Egyptian pharaohs, using gold leaf in the hair. It makes it look quite rich. I didn't really want to use gel or spray, so we kind of went for the real thing, using gold leaf on the head, all over the almost like a skull cap in a way. But then to give it the modern edge, we're sort of making it look very fractured.
And how did you apply the gold to the hair?
It's just using a hairspray, like a wet hairspray, to dry the hair back. And then we're using honey. We're wiping honey over the head. This allows the gold leaf to stick on, placing the hair on, just blowing it on, using a makeup brush just to pat it on, and then drying it in a little bit, and then just with a normal hairbrush, just brushing out the hairline. So you still see the girl's hairline. I didn't want it to look so kind of swimming cap-like. I like the idea that in the back you get these kind of fractured kind of, almost like fractured glass in a way, and it kind of gives it like a little twist to it. That's it.
Looks great, thank you so much, Paul. You know you like it, but you're scared of the shame. What you want? I've managed to grab a moment with Hannah Murray, who is looking after the Topshop Unique makeup today. Hannah, can you talk me through the look? It's a bit different from last season where we saw lots of Dalmatian print.
Exactly, it's very pared down this season. The main product is Skin Glow, which I've basically used all along the cheekbones, the forehead, down the nose, the higher planes of the face, really gives this 3D kind of sculpted face without using any powders or contours. The eyebrows we've made a little bit more boyish, so brushed up and then used the eyes brown powder to brush through with an angled brush. And then lip balm and a bit of concealer where needed. I mean, it's super simple, but actually in the light out there, they look so strong and cool and very top shot, like really easy.
What can you do with curly, frizzy hair? Make it go away. New Frizzies 3-Day Straight, our first styling spray made with keratin. It works with your hair straighteners to help create a straight style that can last not one, not two, but 3 days. 3-Day Straight, only from John Frieda.